is up, guys, how are we doing today? And in this video I'm going to show you everything on my top shelf of my shelves. I am here. You can see my shadow is at the curtains there. But I can't literally physically show you me, because look at my bed. It is completely covered in stuff. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. We're going to do the biggest things first, then go down to the smallest. So let's get all the biggest things. So that's a big thing, that's a big thing, and that's a big thing. Let's get all the big things out of the way first. So first up, we have a microscope to look at things, obviously. Now, I think I tried to open this when I was like 8 or something. Oh, it's open. Close enough. Wait, so if I'm 14 now. Take away 2016. Please. Just do a calculator. So then 13 take away 7. 6. Not 8. 2 years off. But well. And it's 400 times zoom to a 640 times zoom. Next up, we've got this 3D puzzle of Earth. And it's got Africa on it and everywhere. So we've got some things on here. So it says inhalant 18 numrete constof pizile 6 tile stanfus puzzlihe antilige, and that's translated to English is 118 numbered puzzle pieces plus 6 part stand plus puzzling aid plus instructions. And I can tell you some of the animals on here. So we've got in between Liberia and Algeria, we've got a fennec fox. Actually, I'm not going to say everything because that's all. Next up, we've got got a 3D West Ham United London Stadium puzzle that I will do eventually. And it says bring your favourite team stadium to life in 3D. Absolutely, assembly time about 120 minutes. No tools or glue are required. Then we'll do the fattest, the widest things. So that's wide, that's definitely wide. And all of this lot, Jesus Christ. Hoo-ha. Yeet. 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 But first we've got to do this. We've got a West Ham United hat. It's a bit warm to wear like an actual mitten hat. But I'll go through the warmth with it on. There we go. Next up, we've got a Minions Annual 2016. with some models inside of some minions. And we've also got a picture of the Despicable Me film. No, the Minions film. Like, the Minions film. We've got a... So, these are all the models we've got. We've got a Stuart model of him in a coat. No, a... whatever you call it. We've got another Stuart... Two Stuart other models. We've got a Kevin Corgi and Corgi model. We've also got a Kevin and another Kevin and Corgi model, and that's a Corgi. And we've got a King Bob model, and then the other parts of the King Bob model. And then more stuff about the Minions film. I think the Minions film was actually released in 2016, so that's probably why it's an annual of 2016. Right, let's go back in time. Back to the ultimate footy annual of 2016. And that was by Match of the Day. That's when, obviously, when Chelsea won the Premier League. And I think there's some posters in there. And that was when Hazard was rising. And we've got the Borussia... We've got the yellow wall there. If you don't know what the yellow wall is, it's the binding. It's the Borussia Dortmund fans. We've got a CR7 poster. Memphis Depay was the top goal scorer of this season. And we've also got a finding stuff thing. And I think that's all the posters. It's just the one, because I think we've taken out the others. Nope, there's a Cesc Fabregas and Luis Suarez. I have got a Luis Suarez poster. We've got a Christian Eriksen poster, an Aguero poster, he's now retired. And that's all that's in there. We did have a Benteke poster, a Pogba poster, a Barkley poster as well in there. We've got the 2018 annual, which had the... Wait, no, that's the 2019 annual I'm thinking of. This is obviously the annual of Dele when he was incredible at Tottenham, but still absolutely awful. I didn't actually mean that, so... Oh, this is interesting. So we've got some Premier League legends in here. Like Premier League Dream Team. So, the goalkeepers are Peter Schmeichel, and his main club was Manchester United. And we've got some more goalkeepers here. Petr Cech, main clubs Arsenal and Chelsea. Thibaut Courtois, main club Chelsea. Pepe Reina, main club Liverpool. Hugo Lloris, main club Tottenham. And I'll tell you all of them that I was alive during. So Thibaut Courtois, Petr Cech and Hugo Lloris, when they were all playing for Premier League clubs. I was not around when Pepe Reina was playing for Liverpool, but I think he played for Aston Villa as well. And the rest of them, apart from David De Gea, which are the best of the rest, I have not been around to see physically play. And they are Edwin van der Sar, with his main clubs being United and Fulham. David James, his clubs mainly being Liverpool and Portsmouth. David Seaman, main club being Arsenal. And David De Gea, which is the obvious one that I've been around to see. Next up, we have David Luiz, who I've been around to see. Vincent Kompany, who I've been around to see. And David Luiz's main club is Chelsea. Obviously, Vincent Kompany, he is playing his first game in the Premier League after getting Burnley back promoted. He has to return to the Etihad for his first game. And that's Vincent Kompany, and his main club being City. And David Luiz's main club being Chelsea. I think I've already said that. obviously Rio Ferdinand was playing for QPR when I was around, so interesting. And his main clubs on here, though, are United and West Ham, the club that I support. Obviously, we've got John Terry, main club being Chelsea, and I was around to see him, not when he was physically playing for Chelsea, but when he was, like, leaving to go to, like, Aston Villa, that sort of time. I was born in 2009, if you didn't realise. Jamie Carragher, for Liverpool, didn't see him play. I think I might have done, I don't know. I don't know when he retired. Jap Stam, never even heard of him, but apparently he played for United. Tony Adams, obviously everyone's heard of him. Didn't see him play though. Ledley King, I saw him when he was retiring, I think. I don't know. Gareth Southgate, obviously didn't. And Ledley King's main club was Tottenham. Gareth Southgate, Aston Villa and West Brom. And Middlesbrough, sorry. As soon as it says Borough. Borough. Yeah, it is Middlesbrough, okay. Because it does say Borough. Okay. Yeah, I get it. Yeah. Didn't see him play though, obviously. Sol Campbell played for Arsenal and Tottenham. Bit of a controversial one there. Nemanja Vidic, I did see play. He was playing in 2009. Did retire in 2011 though. Slaven Distin, I didn't know he played for City, but I didn't know he played for Bournemouth and Everton. Must have played for City before I was born, obviously. Sami Hyypa, never even heard of him either. Sami Hyypa, never even heard of that guy in my entire life existence. So his main club was Liverpool, so I'm pretty shocked about that one. Martin Keown, I've heard of him, but obviously weren't around when he was playing. Richard Carvajal, never even heard of him either. Main club was Chelsea though. Toby Alderweireld, main club Tottenham, obviously saw him play. Laurent Koscielny, saw him play for Arsenal. Gary Cahill, saw him playing for Chelsea but not Bolton. John Stones, main clubs were City and Everton, and I saw him play for both of them. Vertonghen's main club was Tottenham. And oh my god, there's so many others. Jeez. Europe's top goal scorer is Alan Shearer with 260 goals. Nearly been overtaken by Harry Kane, Newcastle's legends. Newcastle and... Why do I keep forgetting? Blackburn Rovers. For Asia and Oceania's top goal scorer is Viduku. He played for Newcastle, Middlesbrough and Leeds. And he scored 92 goals. I'm surprised Tim Cahill isn't on. We've got Jason Park. We haven't got Tim Cahill. And we've got Okazaki as well. Oh, it is Asia and Oceania. So that makes sense. Tim Cahill was a really good goal scorer. I'm surprised he ain't on here. D.A. Dogba scored 104 goals, and he's from Ivory Coast and played for Chelsea. South America, I think you can already guess, yeah, it's Sergio Aguero with 122. Obviously played for City. Dwight York for Trinidad and Tobago in North America. I didn't even know he played for Trinidad and Tobago. Clint Dempsey coming second there. Javier Hernandez got 37, that's obviously probably when he was playing for United. Got a Firmino poster in here.
Oh, where's that poster? Oh, I have that poster as well. And a Harry Kane poster, obviously. And that's just to wrap all those things up. Excuse me. Got another annual. Here's the 2019 one. With the Premier League legends, hero, past, present and future. That's obviously... Oh, here. This is the first one that I had. It's... This book belongs to me, Craig, and I was 9 at the time. My highlight of 2018 was the Russian World Cup final. And the way I spell Russian is weird. I spell it R-U-S-H-H-O-N. Kylian Mbappe. Yep. Youngest player to win a World Cup, I think. Oh, we've got the A to Z of the world's best players of 2019 annual. And A is for Antoine Griezmann. Obviously now, absolutely crap. Bernardo Silva, still playing for Man City now. Ronaldo, completely disappeared into thin air. Just like everyone's going. Sadly. D is for David De Gea. Absolute crap now, as well. Eden Hazard, absolute crap now as well. Fernandinho, he's just disappeared. Gareth Bale, retired because of golf. Harry Kane, still playing for the same club. You need to leave, mate. You need to leave. Isco. I honestly don't even know where he is. James Rodriguez, he's in Qatar. Ain't got a Scooby-Doo wise there. Kylian Mbappe, obviously have links to Real Madrid. Again. Lionel Messi, he's gone to the MLS to play for Inter Miami. Although they came bottom of their league. Mohamed Salah, obviously one of the greatest players to ever grace football. The Egyptian king. He did play for Chelsea though, if you didn't know that. Now you do. Neymar, he nearly signed for West Ham when he was at Santos, but he refused the offer. We nearly got Neymar, but he refused the offer when he was at Santos and decided to become one of the greatest players to ever grace football. Obviously now, played for PSG, but does have links to Manchester United and Barcelona. Ousmane Dembele, he's just disappeared. Phil Coutinho, he's absolute crap now. Playing for Aston Villa in the Premier League. Quincy Promes also could actually be arrested for life after assault on outside pub in Russia when he was playing for Spartak. While he's playing for Spartak Moscow. The retired Sergio Aguero, obviously everyone knows why he retired, but if you don't know, here's a quick breakup. He had slowness of breath when he was playing for Barcelona and couldn't play on because the doctor said so. Oh, I've got I'm an idiot. So Robert Lewandowski, obviously still playing for Bayern Munich and winning everything there. We've got Toni Kroos, I have absolutely no idea where he is. U is for someone I've never even heard of in my entire life. Euros Spagic. Vincent Kompany, obviously now Burnley's manager, and will play against his former club, where he retired. As the first game of the season is Burnley versus Manchester City. Willian, obviously, he went from really good at Chelsea to absolute crap. And he's playing for Fulham at the moment. Chan Shaqiri, he's just disappeared into thin air. No one knows where he is. He's somewhere on the planet. Uri Tielemans, obviously, recently signed for Aston Villa from relegated Leicester. And Zlatan Ibrahimovic, one of the greatest footballers of all time, that has never won a Ballon d'Or. Obviously retired. Now we've got the past, present and future players of the Premier League, and we'll see if they actually did get the correct, did be a future player of the club. Thierry Henry played for Arsenal between 1999 and 2007, obviously rejoined them in 2012. One of the greatest Arsenal players also was around when they were Invincibles in 2006, I think. Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang could have been a superstar, but then decided to leave to Chelsea. No, leave to Barcelona. Wait. No, I actually don't know where he went before Chelsea, but I think he went somewhere else before Chelsea. And now he's at Barcelona now. Emile Smith Rowe, no one knows what happened to him. Ted McDonnell Dougal, 1969 to 1972 and 1978 to 80. Never even heard of him in my life. I mean, it is a black and white photo, so he's probably like dead now. No harm done. Nathan Ake obviously left the City after Bournemouth got relegated. Lewis Cook, no one knows what happened to him either. Bobby Zamora was Brighton. This is the 2019 annual, so they won't have the likes of like all those other clubs on it. That's why you can't hear Aston Villa. Bobby Zamora played for Brighton. I didn't even know that. He played between 2003 and 2015 and 2015 to 2016. Lewis Dunk, no one knows what's happened to him. I think he's left Brighton now. Max Sandras is 19 years old, back then he was, and no one knows what's happened to him either. Stephen Defoe, he's now retired from football. And Jimmy McCloy, never even heard of him either. Dwight McNeil is obviously now playing for Everton, who nearly escaped relegation. But I don't think Everton are going down. I think Everton are going down, I meant to say, this season. I think Everton, Luton and Forest are going down. Not in that order. Cardiff, they got Robin Earnshaw. I have heard of him, but I can't remember where I heard of him and why I've heard of him. Alan Gunnarsson played for them since 2012, has now left to Iceland, to an Icelandic club. James Waite, never even heard of him, so. Oh, now we're getting somewhere. Eden Hazard, Gianfranco Zola, obviously everyone's heard of him. The incredible Italian showboater for Chelsea. Eden Hazard was the superstar, but now he's absolute crap now. I'm playing for Real Madrid in La Liga. Callum Hudson-Odoi. Honestly, I have absolutely no idea where he is now. Ian Wright is for Crystal Palace. Wilfred Zaha, obviously, I think he's left Crystal Palace now. I can't remember. And Nyan Kirby is still at Crystal Palace. He's now really good. Dixie Dean. He's obviously dead now, played between 1925 and 1937. Jordan Pickford, he's still at Everton. And Morgan Feeney, he's left Everton on a free transfer. Tom Kent, I'm not going to do the legends unless I know them. Now we continue. Tom Kearney, obviously still playing for Fulham. Ryan Sessegnon is playing, no, Stefan Sessegnon playing for Tottenham, and Ryan Sessegnon, I don't know where he is. Aaron Moy, he's still playing. He left to China from Huddersfield. Matty Daly, I have no idea where he is. Gary Lineker, obviously the pundit for Match of the Day, which we watch. And I'm already curious about what the new Match of the Day is going to look like and how Gary Lineker is going to be feeling without Leicester in it. Jamie Vardy, obviously not leaving Leicester City. He's staying at them because he's already been at them in the Championship before. Harvey Barnes, however, does have links to West Ham United. Kenny Dalglish, one of the footballing greats for Liverpool. Mo Salah, one of the footballing greats for Liverpool. Ryan Brewster, playing for Sheffield United. Colin Bell obviously died in 2020 something. It's either 2020, 2021 or 2022. It was not 2023. There was a lot of 2020s just then. Kevin De Bruyne, one of the footballing greats who used to play for Chelsea. Phil Foden still plays for City as well. George Best obviously dies of an infection in 19 something. David De Gea, absolute crap. Angel Gomez, I haven't got a Scooby Doo where he is. Alan Shearer, Newcastle legend, Newcastle and always get it mixed up between Blackburn Rovers and Bolton, but it is Blackburn Rovers. The legend of Blackburn Rovers and Bolton. No, Blackburn Rovers and Newcastle, and is obviously a pundit on Match of the Day now. Jonjo Shelvey, obviously now playing for Nottingham Forest. He hasn't really done much at Forest than he did at Newcastle. I do have a poster of him there, as he is my favourite footballer. But not... I do like him. I just don't know why. Maybe it's because he's bald. And maybe it's because I'm... got, like, no hair, but I do actually have hair. I mean, what's this stuff on my head, if it's not hair? Oh, speaking about my head... I've got a massive forehead, look at it, Jesus Christ. Talking about Jesus Christ, this video is 27 minutes in. And I've still got a whole bunch of stuff to go through. Seeing Longstaff, obviously, has left Newcastle now. Relegated Southampton, sees Matt Letizia. Ain't got a scoop to do where he is. Ryan Bertrand, playing for Leicester, who also got relegated, so you basically didn't. You would have got relegated even if you didn't leave Southampton. Jake Volkings, ain't got a Scooby Doo where he is. Harry Kane, obviously still at Tottenham but should leave at some point. Olivier Skip, still playing for Tottenham. John Barnes, absolute legend for Watford and legend for Liverpool, I think he played for. But absolute legend, no doubt. He was an amazing left winger. Adebayor Decore, ain't got a Scooby Doo where he is. And Chuto Fernandez has already left Watford with only being there for one season, which was 2019. Bobby Moore, absolute legend, died in 1993 on the 23rd of February. So yes, his 30-year anniversary was this year, on the February 23rd. Marko Arnautovic, obviously playing in wherever he's playing for now. Ain't got a Scooby Doo where he is. Declan Rice, he was the wonder kid when he was 19. Now absolute hammer legend now. Absolute hammer great. And might be either moving to Arsenal or City, but I don't think he's going to Arsenal. Could be going to City though, although they literally did just sign a midfielder, so I don't know why they're trying to sign someone else. Ruben Neves obviously has links to Saudi Arabia and Newcastle. Morgan Gibbs-White is still at Wolves. That was a lot of information. Now I've got the 2020 match angle. There isn't anything really show you a 2019 one. I don't think I did actually show the front of it. There's the front of it. If I did, then I'm dumb. I mean, it was like 10 minutes ago or something. It's half an hour. Now we've got the 2022 annual, last year's one. No, the year before last year's one. And it might have some... Oh, it's got Zinedine Zidane as a poster. I don't think we've taken any posters about this one. Diego Maradona is also in it. Gazza! The one who had the weirdest celebration out of anyone. He's played for England at a World Cup. Got Xavi Hernandez. Obviously Barca's manager now. Rudiger. Don't know where he is. David Suka. Never even heard of him. R9. JJ Okocha. Luis Figo. Del Piero. And there are all the posters out that one. Now we're on the 2023 annual, the one from last year. It's got the new match of the day thing in it. That's obviously when Real Madrid won the Champions League. Posters are Heung-min Son, Lionel Messi, CR7, Neymar, Mbappe, Kane. Kevin De Bruyne, Robert Lewandowski, Pedri, Sadio Mane, Van Dijk, and that's about it. That's all the annuals done. Now we get on the fatter things, like when I'm with arm and stuff like that. Let me go on the flatter things. So the bigger the better, as I say. So we've got funny stories and the funny stories for 6-year-olds. There. I mean, there is 263 pages. We've got The Christmasaurus, my favourite Christmas book by Tom Fletcher, and the beautiful red outline around the outside. Look at it, that looks beautiful. Now you've got the snowflakes inside. I used to always read this book when I was in year 6 at primary. Dog at the Door, which I think I took from primary school but never gave back. Wait, no. I took it for homework at primary school, but because it was locked down at the same time, I couldn't give it back, so that's why I still have it. Next up, we have a notepad, which has the colours of light blue / aqua, yellow, dark blue, orange, and then an even lighter blue, a light blue, aqua / light blue, and yellow. We've got in here, once at the tree, and then I put once with someone in a box, the, and then I drew a tree, and then dot dot dot. And then at the bottom there, it says, the pondweed grew. It's that blue writing there. And then which one has lion as 3 votes, tiger as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 votes, black panther, everyone chose that, frog and then kangaroo with only 2 votes. Bad for kangaroo. Oh my god, I've just realised what this is. Which one do you most like again? Tinsel I put on there. And I couldn't even spell flamingo then. I spell it F-E-L. Flamingo. Flamingo. And then Leicester City plays to sign. This was the 2019. FIFA 2019. No, FIFA 20. And I spelled Leicester S-L-E-S-T-E-R. Bill Hamid from DC United. Sam Ling from Leyton Orient. Lanzini, obviously leaving West Ham now, but wasn't then. Raphael, he's retired now. He was the one who got red card for something David Luiz did, which was when he was smoking, when he was playing for Manchester United. Bowling leaderboard. Okay. Which one again? No one choosing. Oh my god, Jesus Christ. Transfers I forgot. Jonathan Hogg to Exeter. Randa Exeter City player to Huddersfield. Alexandru Milik to Watford. Kieran Dennis to Napoli. Sadio Mane to City. Raheem Sterling to Liverpool. Koulibaly to Liverpool. Joe Gomez to Napoli. Mesut Ozil to Watford. What the hell? Harry Arter to Bournemouth. And some 60s rated Bournemouth player to Cardiff. Transfer position changes. Renato Sanchez to Acam. Quinteria to Acam. Ander Herrera to Acam. Pascal Gross to Acam. Joe Willock to a centre mid. Moussa Dembele to... Oh my god. What is a baby snail called? What is a baby turkey called? Oh, this is interesting. Okay, so... You have 10 seconds to guess. I'll wait for it to hit actually 10 seconds. It'll be easier. Okay, what is a baby snail called? Answer down in the comments below. I'll tell you at the end of the video. What is a baby turkey called? What is a baby fox called? What's a baby squirrel called? What's a baby platypus called? Baby shark, baby narwhal, baby giraffe, baby parrot, baby horse, baby owl, baby alpaca. Answer those down in the comment section down below. And, yeah. I'll tell you at the end of the video. Right, and here I've got Chelsea, Arsenal, Watford, Leicester, Bristol City, Birmingham. See. That's it. That's literally it. Next up, we've got Gangster Granny Strikes again. We've got this book, which I got recently, which is Out of This World. And it's got all cool bits about space in here, which is very interesting. I've got this book to enter a competition about winning David Walliam's new book, World's Worst Monsters. Imagine if like Pennywise was in there or something. Jesus Christ. Now we're getting somewhere where I haven't looked for a while. Hansel and Gretel. Ladybug book. I was probably like 4 then. Rags the Brave Puppy. He was the one who rests at 87 Chestnut Drive. Rags is the bounciest, noisiest puppy there is. One night Rags smells danger and is... and has to be bouncy and noisy and brave. Bony story, type a bony story. Red button for that joke. Titles available in this series. Fairy Tale Sunshine, Blue Saves the Day, Doug the Busy Digger, Patty Pig. Bruv, are you trying to rhyme? Or are you trying to make jokes? Although it is a bit of alliteration, so. Patty Pig Gets a Job and the Troublesome Twins. Rages age 5 plus. He rescued his family from a fire. That's what you can smell. Next up, we've got my, yeah. This is my homework book from year 6. And on me, that's me in a life jacket. That's me with my, rest in peace, Rosie and Izzy, who's still around. Me as a baby. Look at my chubby face. I was so chubby. Me with a hedgehog. And then me really small there. And on here we've got me at Felixstowe. Me in something. Me underneath a gas store at Raw. It's what it's now called, but it was called Dinosaur Adventure. And then me in a ball thing at Felixstowe. And Jesus Christ. I did a lot of things in here. What do I feel like? Frustrated are you? How frustrated are you? How are you angry or sad? Are you angry or sad? What will happen to you? Have you thought? Oh, a lot of picture in here. Right, time to read my year 6 picture thing. Stay and explore the place. The girl has black black hair and black shorts is what it's supposed to say. And the flyer flies buzzing happily around. And my teacher in year 6 stamped it as good. Okay. That was the most confusing year 6 homework book I've ever gone through in my life. We've got a bird watching book. I think I have oh my god. I'm just going to pretend I never saw what I just saw. Okay, I'm going to show you. Yeah, a lot of people have written in this book. I don't know how. 101 Dalmatians. Little Ladybird book. It's only got 42 pages in it. And the film was like about an hour and something minutes. Next up, we've got Astrosaurus. And this one's the Star Pirates. And then we've got another Astrosaurus. This one's the Sun Snatchers. We've got Journey to the Lost Temple, which I've never read. It's an urban puzzle adventure. Oh yeah, it is. Interesting. And then finally, 43 minutes. That must be the annuals that I was going through. I'm so dumb. Why did I read annuals? And finally, we've got Roald Dahl's Ultra Fantastic Foxes. Mr. Fox, Mrs. Fox, and their small life live in fear of the terrible farmers Bogus, Bunce, and Bean. But Mr. Fox has a plan, and it might just save them. Ellipsis. AKA dun, dun, dun! Stickers in it. There's a Happy Meal sticker. Yes, I need to take this out right now. How do I take this out? I think I just rip it out. I think that's what you actually do, you just rip it out. Yeah, you do just rip it out. Okay. Let me get the Happy Meal sticker. I want to stick it on my computer. Not like on my computer. There's like a Roald Dahl sticker on there. Look at that. Roald Dahl. Stick it over the camera. No, you don't know what I'm doing. a Happy Meal sticker. Right, let's replace my Roald Dahl sticker with the Happy Meal sticker. See if there's a difference, or is it just the same? Yeah, it's the same. I'm gonna stick them both on my laptop. There we go. And I think I might put the foxes. Right there. Foxes can go there. Right there. No, I'll show you. If I can. They're there if you can see them. Right. There. Right there. Right there. Oh yeah, it's bugs, Bruce and Beans. Oh, well, the sticker's falling. So, well, I might just keep them there for safekeeping. Look at that pile. Just look at the pile. That's a lot of stuff. That don't even look like a lot of stuff. But I managed to get a 46-minute video, and yet my other one is like 17 minutes long, I think. But anyway, guys, that's all for today. If you did enjoy this video, make sure to give it a massive thumbs up. That will really help me out. And while you're there, subscribe. It's totally free. And if you hate my videos, you can always unsub later. And obviously, comment down. Oh. I forgot the answers. So a baby snail is called a ponchoch. A baby turkey is called a poutlets. A baby fox is called a pup. Baby squirrel, kittens. Baby platypus, puggles. Baby shark, pups. I already knew that. Baby narwhal is a calf. Baby giraffe is a calf. Baby parrot is a chick. Baby horse is a foal. Baby owl is a fledgling. And the baby alpaca is an error. Is a cereal. And comment down below what your favourite thing out of all of that was. And while you're there, also subscribe to my brother's channel and my reaction channel. They'll be in the description below. And click on one of the videos on screen in front of you, here or here, or the link to my brother's channel, which is here, and as I've already said, is down in the description below. And if you haven't had it enough to see my boring face yet, click on one of the videos. Peace!